Good morning students, welcome back to online class. Last class we have discussed about velocity, speed, acceleration, distance and displacement. Today we are going to discuss about distance versus time graphs. Based on that, what are the possibility of graph is there that we are going to discuss. Follow me. Listen me carefully students, you have to imagine a car traveling along a straight line away from the starting point O. The distance of the car is measured for every second. The distance and time are recorded and a graph is plotted using the data. The results for four possible journeys today we are going to discuss. Listen, the first one, look at the tabular column. Here time values they have given 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are the time values in second. Distance, for each second they have given the same distance as 20, so which means there is no movement, there is no movement in the car which is at rest. Car is at rest. So based on the given data, they have plotted the graph. So for each second we are having the same value as 20. So we are getting a straight line. We are getting a straight line across the x-axis. So the graph has zero gradient. Gradient is nothing but inclined part of a graph is called gradient. Here there is no inclined part, we are having only the straight line. So they are saying zero gradient. The distance is constant for every second. The distance is constant for every second. So we are telling car at rest based on the given data. Let me pass on to the next tabular column. A car traveling at uniform speed of 10 meter second power minus 1. Listen to the tabular column. For each second, the distance is getting increase. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Here, the distance between the two values are equal. 20 minus 10, 10. 30 minus 20, 10. 40 minus 30, 10. 50 minus 40, what we have? 10. So, already we have discussed about uniform speed. Equal time, equal interval of time, equal distance covered by equal interval of time, which gives the uniform speed. Have you understood students? Equal distance covered by equal interval of time, which gives the uniform speed. So here how we are telling that speed is uniform? Listen, the first one, speed formula already we know well. What's the formula here we have? Speed is equal to distance divided by time. Actually, you have to substitute each value here. First value is what is that? 10 divided by 1. 10 is the distance, 1 is the time. What is the second value? 20 divided by 2. What is the next value? 30 divided by 3. What is the next value? 40 divided by 4. What is the next value? 50 divided by 5. When you cancel this, we are getting equal value as 10. So that what is speed here? Speed is equal to 10 meter per second, which is unit of speed. So that we are telling uniform speed. So, already I told you, equal distance covered by equal interval of time, which gives uniform speed. So by seeing the graph itself, we can say by the given value, when we plot the graph, we are getting a straight line. So by seeing the graph itself, we can say which is uniform or non-uniform. So this graph is straight line from the origin, so that this is uniform speed. Let me pass on to the next graph, which is car traveling at increasing speed. What is that? Car traveling at increasing speed. Look at the data here. For first second, which is equal to distance is equal to 5. Next one is 20. Third second, 45. Fourth second, 80. And the fifth second, 125. The graph has an increasing gradient. The speed increases. The instantaneous speed of the car at t is equal to 3 seconds is given by the gradient of the tangent at that point. Tangent, in sense, you have to draw the straight line here and you have to find out the time and the distance. So what is the t is equal to 3 seconds, which gives the given by the gradient of the tangent at that point, instantaneous, which is instantaneous speed. This graph shows that car traveling at increasing speed but not in uniform. And listen the next one, car traveling at decreasing speed. How we are telling decreasing speed? Listen the data. One for first second, 45 meter, second 80 meter, and listen the data here. So how we have to tell which is speed is decreasing? So let me find out the speed for the first one and the last one. For the first one, listen, already we know the formula, speed is equal to distance divided by time. So based on this, what is the first distance here? 45. What is the time? 1, which is equal to speed is equal to 45 meter per second. So this is the this one is for first second. Let me find out the speed for the last value. What is the distance for the last value here? 125. So 125 meter is the distance divided by 5, which is equal to, you have to cancel this for getting speed. So how to cancel? 1 5s are 5, 2 5s are 10, and remaining 25 is here. 5 5s are 25. So what is speed here? 25 meter per second. So this is for the first value and this is for the last value. In between also, when you simplify in this way, we are getting a decreasing value from the first second. So that we are telling car traveling at decreasing speed. Students, I hope you are all understood. Thank you. Okay, students. Last part, we have discussed distance versus time graphs. Now, speed versus time graph we are going to discuss. Listen me carefully. So let us consider a bus or car traveling from Tanjore to Trichy. The speed of the bus is measured for every second. The speed and time are recorded and a graph is plotted using the data. The results for four possible journeys are going to discuss today. Listen the first one. So what they have given in the tabular column, listen. Time 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 they have given. Speed here 0, which means what is it? The car or bus at rest. The speed remains at 0 meter second power minus 1. So the car or bus has 0 acceleration, which means bus or car at rest. Let me pass on to the next one. bus traveling at uniform speed of meter per second. Uniform speed in sense, we have a 10 meter second power minus 1 for each second, so that we are giving straight line. So the speed remains constant at 10 meter second power minus 1. So the car has zero acceleration. There is no acceleration. Student, already we have discussed about acceleration, which is nothing but change in velocity. Am I right? Change in velocity or change in speed. Here the speed is 10. Am I right? The speed is 10. There is no change in the speed. So there is no acceleration. So the car or bus has zero acceleration. Let me pass on to the next graph. Bus traveling with uniform acceleration. What is that? That word uniform, which means equal interval of time. So here also what we have, equal interval of time and equal interval of speed. So the graph, we are getting straight line, which means bus traveling with uniform acceleration. The speed of the car increases by 10 meter second power minus 1 every second. If you find out the speed value, we are getting 10 meter second power minus 1, which is easily we can find it, student. You know, well, when you divide these values, we are getting equal value, which is 10 meter second power minus 1 for every second. Hence the graph has positive and constant gradient, and the acceleration is constant. And let me pass on to the next one. Bus traveling with uniform deceleration or a negative acceleration, which we already discussed in the acceleration part. Negative acceleration in sense, the speed is constantly decreasing. Decreasing speed only negative acceleration, which we know already. Listen the data. The speed has decreasing for each second. So we are saying that bus traveling with uniform deceleration. Why we are bringing uniform this word? No, we are getting a uniform value, which is 50 minus 40 10 40 minus 30 10, which we like that we are getting is constant value. So the decreasing speed also here constant. And let me pass on to the next one. Bus traveling with increasing acceleration. Bus traveling with increasing acceleration. There is a change in acceleration here. For each second, there is an increasing in speed. So that we are saying that increasing acceleration. The increase in speed is increasing with time. Let me pass on to the next one. Bus traveling with the decreasing acceleration. The same graph already we have discussed for the distance time graph, which means that is decreasing. The values are getting decreasing. When we divide this, we know how it is decreasing. I hope you are all understood, student. Thank you.